Well, not only warm the belly, but they'll warm the soul too. Mm-hmm. Courtney Ralston joins us now to show us how to cook a meal to hit the spot. Thanks for coming in today. We always
do. Hi, thank you.
Thanks for having me. It's always good to come in.
That's
love
it,
yeah. Love doing a bit of cooking.
That's it. Now, winter's coming, so is the cold. What hearty meal are we cooking today?
We are doing a love a one-pan wonder.
Yes.
No one wants extra washing
no.
up. No one wants any washing up.
No.
So we are doing a one-pan creamy chicken Florentine.
Oh.
Ticks all the boxes. Winter's coming. Mother's Day's also coming. I reckon Mum wouldn't mind this for lunch or dinner.
Seems a bit fancy as well for a one-panner.
Look, it sounds fancy, and that's what I'm all about, making things sound fancier than they are. Basically, all it is, and we've skipped ahead, we're using chicken breasts. A lot of people avoid chicken breasts. They think they're going to dry out. So we've got four succulent chicken breasts. All I've done is brown them in a pan with some extra virgin olive oil, salt and pepper, and you want to get this beautiful colour on it.
That's so just brown on the outside, not cooked on the inside.
Yeah,
okay.
And then take the chicken out,
mm-hmm.
and we're just going to let that rest. What that does is let the chicken cook through, stays nice and succulent, so you're not kind of having hard heat on the chicken, and then all of that brown flavour that's in the pan, all of the caramelisation, they call it on MasterChef, I think. All of those, all the caramelisation, you put in some butter, about 40 grams of butter, onion, garlic, some mushrooms. I've used brown mushroom, some Dijon mustard. You can probably tell this is a French dish. Tristan, you're going to add in some chicken stock.
All of it?
Put in half to start with. So what we're doing is making a sauce now.
Okay.
So chicken stock. You can probably smell onions and garlic.
So
they're the base for any delicious meal. I'm using cream, but if you look, if you wanted to do this veggio, I know there's lots of veggios and vegans. You could use an almond milk or a cashew milk.
Yep.
And you could do some really big field mushrooms or eggplants instead of the chicken.
What if you wanted it something a little bit lighter, not the heavy cream? Could you use?
You could use milk.
Milk.
Yeah.
You could use some milk.
But it won't get that texture, will it? Though, if you go something as light as skim milk.
You won't. But I don't mind if you reduce it down a little bit. It smells pretty good, doesn't
okay.
it?
Okay.
I was supposed to add some flour in before the stock.
That's
pretend.
Oh, good. So, will you make mistakes as well? Because I feel like I make too many mistakes.
I can't
get the dinner off the stock without
burning
it.
I make loads of mistakes. And I was like, I could not put the flour in.
That could be your twist. You know, everyone has to put their own twist in this stuff, so it's just a little bit different.
Yeah, so I like to add the flour in a little bit later.
Yeah.
Just to thicken it up a little bit.
Yeah.
And will kids like this, Courtney? Because I've got to tell you a story. I tried to make beef stroganoff for my kids. I slaved over a hot stove to make beef stroganoff.
You did a strong.
They didn't want to eat it. What my four-year-old did eat was half a sausage he found under the couch that had been there for 2 days.
Oh.
Happy to eat that, doesn't want to eat my own cooking.
Oh, no.
So something like this would be good for little young palates, wouldn't it?
Look, kids would love this. And a traditional Florentine would have white wine in it. So my little trick for keeping it kid-friendly, I've used the chicken stock and some Dijon mustard.
Yes.
I reckon kids would love this.
Yeah, chicken's always a goer,
isn't
it?
Anything creamy. And then what we do, Parmesan cheese.
Keep going.
Tristan's done that. I'm not giving you many jobs here, Sarah. Sorry.
She's going to be the taste test.
That's right. I'm just looking
and drooling. Then what you do, chicken and all of the juices go back in.
Yep.
We need some greens.
How much of this cheese are we putting in just
About 30 grams. Do you know what 30 grams?
Nah. How much is this?
A man's
150?
Thumb. A man's thumb size. Yeah, that's probably about 100.
What kind of man?
Hang on, let's...
What
about my thumb? How's your thumb compared to...
God, Sarah's got a bigger thumb than you.
You can't stand halfway up. So, whatever your preference is on cheese, that's how much you put in,
cheese are up.
Kids love cheese. And this is... The mushrooms give us umami, the cheese gives us umami, which kids love. It's that kind of chicken salt flavour. Spinach goes in. But you could put zucchinis, whatever's in season, whatever's cheap at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I know lots of veggies are kind of to-ing and fro-ing in the supermarket with what they cost. But look, this is all about 20 minutes.
Yeah.
You want to feed the family, you could serve it with some rice or some mashed potatoes. And that's basically it. Bit of lemon zest.
So here's a question. So you keep that on the in the pan for how long? Did you say 20 minutes all up?
20 minutes from go to woe.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. The chicken's pretty much three quarters cooked through. All we're doing now is just kind of letting it have a little bath in that Dijon-y, creamy mustard sauce. And that's it there. A little bit of lemon zest. If you want to get fancy, you can put some parsley on there.
Oh, it smells so good.
For someone like myself who isn't very handy in the kitchen, like, what's the first sign that I'm probably leaving it on too long?
If it reduces too much, but you can cover it. I think as long as you've cooked your chicken to start with, you can't go wrong.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You just the aim of chicken is to not kill people with salmonella.
Yeah,
correct. Yeah, yeah.
That's what worries me.
On the plate. And as I said, it's winter, you want a bit of mashed potato. You'd have some rice.
A bit of brown rice would be gorgeous.
Brown rice would be nice and healthy. Crisp salad. 20 minutes, 25 minutes. Bob's your uncle.
Just don't lick the pot. So good. Oh, don't lick the pot. Put it onto a plate.
Don't lick the pot.
Check out more recipes from Courtney. Go to her Instagram page. I often find myself in like a hole of your videos, watching your cooking videos.
Oh, it's a rabbit hole. It's a rabbit hole.
Fantastic. I spent hours on there and I love it. Thank you for coming. It's nice to see you again.
Good to be here.
It's always great to have you here.
Enjoy. Chicken for lunch.
You want to try?
Is this just for keeps?
This is for you. Yeah.
Hey,
don't just look at it.
I said no once.
You know.
I didn't know if it was TV food or not.
No, it's real.
This is Tristan's favourite part.
I've given you no jobs.
No.
And beautiful. Now you're not getting a taste of it.
Oh, I'll eat that green later. Oh.
It's good, right?
My soul is talking to me.